Hello students, this is Taranum Jahan and I'm here with you all people to start the new chapter from your political science. Now here comes your chapter 7, Outcome of Democracy for the class 10th from your civics. So here the main topics that we are going to discuss over here is the features of democracy. Why do we need to think about the outcome of democracy? Which things we need to understand the outcome of the democracy, outcome in various aspects like accountable, responsive and legitimate government, economic growth and development, economic outcome of the democracy, reduction of inequality and poverty, accommodation of social diversity, dignity and freedom of citizens. Now let us see some of the features of the democracy as we have already studied in your previous chapter about the democracy. What democracy gives us? Why we call it our country as a democratic country? Because it promotes equality among the citizens. It enhances the dignity of the individuals. It also improves the quality of decision making and it provides a method to resolve the conflicts. It also allows us a room to correct our mistakes. So these are some of the features of the democracy. Now let us see some of the merits and demerits of democracy. Democracy is the most popular system of government in the modern world. It has various merits. It provides efficient government. It guarantees the rights of the people. And it also provides equality. It educates the people, promotes national character, brings peaceful changes of the government. And it also believes not in the battle axe, but in a ballot box. In democracy, there is no place for rebellion and revolutions. Whereas, apart from these merits, democracy has certain demerits too. Democracy sometimes leads to establish the majority views. Party leaders and political office holders in the government control the citizen and the members of the party also. It does not encourage individuals to give their opinion. It is very expensive form of the government and it is very difficult to prevent corruption and malpractices. It is also known as a government by imature and it leads to the domination of masses. So these are some of the demerits of the democracy. Now let us see the merits and demerits of dictatorship. So first, let us discuss some merits of the dictatorship. Under dictatorship, we have a stability of the government. The government will stay the same in the same times of a political warfare and the inner party turmoil or in the war. This may become a relief to finally have a stable government. And moreover, it is most efficient during emergencies. When a country faces any kind of emergency situation, such as war or a health epidemic, the dictatorship government can prove to be the most efficient one. The reason being that all the decisions are taken by only one person. And under the dictatorship, we have lesser crime rates too. Most of the dictatorship government are a police states. So in a way, there is a low crime rate under such regimes. And moreover, under a dictatorship, the things also happens very quickly. Like in a dictatorship form of a government, all things whether related to governance or a business or anything else happens much quicker than any other type of government. The reason for this is same, that is the decision making lies under the single person. But apart from this merits, there are certain demerits also under the dictatorship. That is nothing but the loss of freedom of choice. Citizens no longer have the choice to choose who governs them. They cannot vote in elections as it is all decided for them. And the next is the government will have the absolute power. The government may not think in the best interest of the people. They may be more interested in building large, lavish palaces for themselves than feeding their people. And also the people may be oppressed by the regime as the government will be intent on keeping their power away from the citizen. So these are some of the disadvantages even. We do have a merits plus demerits even for the dictatorship. Now let's see, why do we need to think about the outcome of the democracy? Why do we access democracy outcomes? So what are the results of the democracy? Now let's start with the comparison. Democracy and other form of the government. Now what is the other form of the government? Dictatorship, monarchy. So we are having multiple options. Whichever is suitable, we are going to opt that. So we like the democracy, we opted for that. Where we have a division of power, even if we see the worldwide, many countries have adopted democracy. Why? We are having advantages in democracy. Like we have liberty, equality, dignity, freedom of speech, etc. But reality of these advantages is the same what they are being said. Do we really enjoy liberty, equality, freedom of speech? Is it so? So if we talk about the reality, we can see a lot of mismatch among them. So we can say democracies seem to be good in principle, but felt not to be so good in its practices. Now, which things we need to understand before the evaluation of the outcome of democracy? Why do we prefer democracy? Only for moral reason? Or there is some other prudential reasons? See, democracies are different in every country. If we compare the political parties and the democracy with India and France, they are totally different. In the same way in USA. So there are large differences in democracy in each country. Thus, we can say that in every country, according to their social, cultural and political, there are different forms from each other. So what is the common point through which we can say that the country is enjoying democracy? That common point we are going to search in this chapter. For democracy, we have certain expectations. If they are not fulfilled, that we discussed among us, that what we want is not enjoying the democracy. How can we say? See, we sit and discuss that what this government is doing, we are not at all enjoying the democracy. How we discuss and say that we are not enjoying democracy? Because under democracy, we have certain kind of expectations. What are those expectations? The expectations in the form of liberty, freedom of speech, equality, etc. If all these things are not being given to us, these are our expectations from the government. If any of one thing is not being given to us, we start complaining about the democracy, isn't it? So this is what we search in democracy. So we cannot see democracy, we feel democracy. In what way? Democracy is a form of a government. It only creates conditions, situations, or base, you can say, where citizens have to take the advantage to achieve the democratic goal. How? Through free and fair elections. Now, what is this free and fair elections, where we have a multiple choice of the parties out of which we are going to select any one? That party is going to win with a majority. But the same thing is not been enjoyed in China. If we take the example, there only one party is standing, and the people have to give the vote to their same party because they don't have any other choice. So here we cannot say that they are enjoying the free and fair elections, though they are democratic. They say that they are a democratic country, but they are not enjoying the free and fair elections. So these are our expectations. This has to be fulfilled. Then only we can say that yes, we are enjoying democracy. So all these things have to be achieved by the people in the democracy to have their goals. Now let us see what are the major areas which are used to analyze the outcome of the democracy. See, under democracy we say that it is accountable, responsive and legitimate. How can we say this, that the democracy is accountable, responsive and legitimate? We have a legitimate government to the people. Through what reasons we say this? Now, through democracy, we say that with the help of a democracy, we have got the economic growth and development. So we are going to discuss in detail how can we say that in a democratic country, we have economic growth and development. In the same manner, we also say that there is the reduction of inequality and poverty. When we are coming towards democracy, we also say that the accommodation of the social diversity is there. Dignity and freedom of the citizen is there in the democracy. So all these major areas we are going to discuss in detail to know the outcome of the democracy under this chapter. So let us see each one of them in detail. Now let us see how does a democracy can produce an accountable, responsive and legitimate government. What do we expect from democracy? What are our expectations when we say that we are in a democratic country? Our expectations are like we should have a right to choose our ruler. We should participate in the decision making, not on all the decisions, like we cannot participate in the defense and GDP, but apart from that we do participate in the decision making. So government should be accountable. Why do we say that the government is accountable to the citizen? Because they are answerable to the citizen whatever work they are doing. Now how they are answerable? See, we are having certain expectations in a democratic government. Whether the government is efficient in decision making or not, we always come to a decision. We always ask the government if they are not up to our mark, or not expected by us, if they are ruling which are against our expectations, then they are answerable to us, isn't it? So we always guide the government in order to take a efficient decision. So how we are taking up the decision that yes, the government is taking up the efficient decision making power is there in the government. So let us see, discuss or compare it with the democratic and non-democratic countries. Let us see how the decision making is efficient, whether the decision making efficient in a democratic or in a non-democratic. So you see, in a non-democratic, decisions are quick, as only one person has to take up the decision. They don't have to go for debate, deliberations and negotiations. Only one person is there in the power and he has to take the quick decision. So in a non-democratic, decisions are quickly taken. Like for example, if you take a Germany, was having a dictatorship, that is Hitler. He just got a thought to attack a Poland. So he went and he attacked. He don't have to wait for debate, deliberations, etc. in order to attack Poland. But in a democratic, decision making power is slow, where we have to go through a lot of debates, negotiations, deliberations, then come to a decision. So we do see a time consuming decisions have been taken in a democratic country. But those decisions which have been taken are very effective and are very qualitative decisions. In a democratic government, decisions are transparent when we are comparing it to the non-democratic countries. So here we can say that yes, the decisions are completely transparent and these citizens, they have a right to know them before they have been followed, isn't it? So they are transparent when the decisions have been taken by the government. Now let us see the merits and demerits of dictatorship. So first, let us discuss some merits of the dictatorship. Under dictatorship, we have a stability of the government. The government will stay the same in the same times of a political warfare and the inner party turmoil or in the war. This may become a relief to finally have a stable government. And moreover, it is most efficient during emergencies. When a country faces any kind of emergency situation, such as war or a health epidemic, the dictatorship government can prove to be the most efficient one. The reason being that all the decisions are taken by only one person. And under the dictatorship, we have lesser crime rates too. Most of the dictatorship government are a police states. So in a way, there is a low crime rate under such regimes. And moreover, under a dictatorship, the things also happens very quickly. Like in a dictatorship form of a government, all things whether related to governance or a business or anything else happens much quicker than any other type of government. The reason for this is same. That is, the decision making lies under the single person. But apart from this merits, there are certain demerits also under the dictatorship. That is nothing but the loss of freedom of choice. Citizens no longer have the choice to choose who governs them. They cannot vote in elections as it is all decided for them. And the next is the government will have the absolute power. The government may not think in the best interest of the people. They may be more interested in building large, lavish palaces for themselves than feeding their people. And also, the people may be oppressed by the regime, as the government would be intent on keeping their power away from the citizen. So now let's see, why do we need to think about the outcome of the democracy? Why do we access democracy outcomes? So what are the results of the democracy? Now let's start with the comparison. Democracy and other form of the government. Now what is the other form of the government? Dictatorship, monarchy. So we are having multiple options. Whichever is suitable, we are going to opt that. So we like the democracy, we opted for that. Where we have a division of power, even if we see the worldwide, many countries have adopted democracy. Why? We are having advantages in democracy. Like we have liberty, equality, dignity, freedom of speech, etc. But reality of these advantages is the same what they are being said. Do we really enjoy liberty, equality, freedom of speech? Is it so? So if we talk about the reality, we can see a lot of mismatch among them. So we can say democracies seem to be good in principle, but felt not to be so good in its practices. Now, which things we need to understand before the evaluation of the outcome of democracy? Why do we prefer democracy? Only for moral reason? Or there is some other prudential reasons? See, democracies are different in every country. If we compare the political parties and the democracy with India and France, they are totally different. In the same way, in USA. So there are large differences in democracy in each country. Thus, we can say that in every country, according to their social, cultural and political, there are different forms from each other. So what is the common point through which we can say that the country is enjoying democracy? That common point we are going to search in this chapter. For democracy, we have certain expectations. If they are not fulfilled, that we discussed among us, that what we want is not enjoying the democracy. How can we say? See, we sit and discuss that what this government is doing, we are not at all enjoying the democracy. How we discuss and say that we are not enjoying democracy? Because under democracy, we have certain kind of expectations. What are those expectations? The expectations in the form of liberty, freedom of speech, equality, etc. If all these things are not being given to us, these are our expectations from the government. If any of one thing is not being given to us, we start complaining about the democracy, isn't it? So this is what we search in democracy. So we cannot see democracy, we feel democracy. In what way? Democracy is a form of a government. It only creates conditions, situations, or base, you can say, where citizens have to take the advantage to achieve the democratic goal. How? through free and fair elections. Now, what is this free and fair elections, where we have a multiple choice of the parties out of which we are going to select any one? That party is going to win with a majority. But the same thing is not been enjoyed in China. If we take the example, there only one party is standing, and the people have to give the vote to their same party because they don't have any other choice. So here we cannot say that they are enjoying the free and fair elections, though they are democratic. They say that they are a democratic country, but they are not enjoying the free and fair elections. So these are our expectations. This has to be fulfilled. Then only we can. Now let us see how does a democracy can produce an accountable, responsive and legitimate government. What do we expect from democracy? What are our expectations when we say that we are in a democratic country? Our expectations are like we should have a right to choose our ruler. We should participate in the decision making, not on all the decisions, like we cannot participate in the defense and GDP, but apart from that, we do participate in the decision making. So government should be accountable. Why do we say that the government is accountable to the citizen? Because they are answerable to the citizen whatever work they are doing. Now, how they are answerable? See, we are having certain expectations in a democratic government. Whether the government is efficient in decision making or not, we always come to a decision. Now, let us see the merits and demerits of dictatorship. So first, let us discuss some merits of the dictatorship. Under dictatorship, we have a stability of the government. The government will stay the same in the same times of a political warfare and the inner party turmoil or in the war. This may become a relief to finally have a stable government. And moreover, it is most efficient during emergencies. When a country faces any kind of emergency situation, such as war or a health epidemic, the dictatorship government can prove to be the most efficient one. The reason being that all the decisions are taken by only one person. And under the dictatorship, we have lesser crime rates too. Most of the dictatorship government are a police states. So in a way, there is a low crime rate under such regimes. And moreover, under a dictatorship, the things also happens very quickly. Like in a dictatorship form of a government, all things whether related to governance or a business or anything else happens much quicker than any other type of government. The reason for this is same, that is, the decision making lies under the single person. But apart from this merits, there are certain demerits also under the dictatorship. That is nothing but the loss of freedom of choice. Citizens no longer have the choice to choose who governs them. They cannot vote in elections as it is all decided for them. And the next is the government will have the absolute power. The government may not think in the best interest of the people. They may be more interested in building large lavish palaces for themselves than feeding their people. And also the people may be oppressed by the regime as the government would be intent on keeping their power away from the citizen. So these are some of the disadvantages. Even we do have a merits plus demerits even for the dictatorship. Now let's see, why do we need to think about the outcome of the democracy? Why do we access democracy outcomes? So what are the results of the democracy? Now let's start with the comparison. Democracy and other form of the government. Now what is the other form of the government? Dictatorship, monarchy. So we are having multiple options. Whichever is suitable, we are going to opt that. So we like the democracy, we opted for that. Where we have a division of power, even if we see the worldwide, many countries have adopted democracy. Why? We are having advantages in democracy. Like we have liberty, equality, dignity, freedom of speech, etc. But reality of these advantages is the same what they are being said.
Do we really enjoy liberty, equality, freedom of speech? Is it so? So, if we talk about the reality, we can see a lot of mismatch among them. So, we can say democracies seem to be good in principle, but felt not to be so good in its practices. Now, which things we need to understand before the evaluation of the outcome of democracy? Why do we prefer democracy? Only for moral reason? Or there is some other prudential reasons? See, democracies are different in every country. If we compare the political parties and the democracy with India and France, they are totally different. In the same way, in USA. So, there are large differences in democracy in each country. Thus, we can say that in every country, according to their social, cultural and political, there are different forms from each other. So, what is the common point through which we can say that the country is enjoying democracy? That common point we are going to search in this chapter. For democracy, we have certain expectations. If they are not fulfilled, that we discussed among us, that what we want is not enjoying the democracy. How can we say? See, we sit and discuss that what this government is doing, we are not at all enjoying the democracy. How we discuss and say that we are not enjoying democracy? Because under democracy, we have certain kind of expectations. What are those expectations? The expectations in the form of liberty. Now let us see how does a democracy can produce an accountable, responsive and legitimate government. What do we expect from democracy? What are our expectations when we say that we are in a democratic country? Our expectations are like we should have a right to choose our ruler. We should participate in the decision making, not on all the decisions, like we cannot participate in the defense and GDP, but apart from that, we do participate in the decision making. So, government should be accountable. Why do we say that the government is accountable to the citizen? Because they are answerable to the citizen whatever work they are doing. Now, how they are answerable? See, we are having certain expectations in a democratic government. Whether the government is efficient in decision making or not, we always come to a decision. We always ask the government if they are not up to our mark, not expected by us, if they are ruling which are against our expectations, then they are answerable to us, isn't it? So we always guide the government in order to take a efficient decision. So how we are taking up the decision that yes, the government is taking up the efficient decision making power is there in the government. So let us see, discuss or compare it with the democratic and non-democratic countries. Let us see how the decision making is efficient, whether the decision making efficient in a democratic or in a non-democratic. So you see, in a non-democratic, decisions are quick, as only one person has to take up the decision. They don't have to go for debate, deliberations and negotiations. Only one person is there in the power and he has to take the quick decision. So, in a non-democratic, decisions are quickly taken. Like for example, if we take a Germany, was having a dictatorship, that is Hitler. He just got a thought to attack a Poland. So, he went and he attacked. He don't have to wait for debate, deliberations, etc. in order to attack Poland. But in a democratic, decision-making power is slow, where we have to go through a lot of debates, negotiations, deliberations, then come to a decision. So we do see a time-consuming decisions have been taken in a... Now, if you closely look at this image, you can see that on your left-hand side, the person holding a bag called government is nothing but he's a person who is a government, who is a representative of that country. And over him, it has been written that what he knows about you. What he knows is nothing but what government knows about the public. And on the other side, there is the two people standing over there and holding a bag called public. That is nothing but these people are the public, that is we people, the citizens. And over them, it has been written that what you know about it. Now, through this image, what is the criteria of this image? What does this cartoon shows you? It shows that how the government is keeping an eye on the citizen through a lens, that is telescope, and knows each and every detail about the citizen. But on the other hand, the public, that is nothing but the citizen, they have no knowledge, no such information about the government. The government of India has a various tools through which information about the citizen can be taken. For example, Aadhaar card, ration cards, and the voter identity card, etc. Every 10 years, the government conducts census. In this census, there are the records of each adult member of the family, along with his or her sex, age, and education. There is a provision of registering birth, marriage, and death of the family members with a government institution. So here you can see that the government is having each and every small information about you. But you don't have even a small information regarding the government. How, what exactly you know about the government, how they are working on you. You don't have even a single knowledge about it. But the government is having a complete information about you. Now let's see, why do we need to think about the outcome of the democracy? Why do we access democracy outcomes? So what are the results of the democracy? Now let's start with the comparison. Democracy and other form of the government. Now what is the other form of the government? Dictatorship, monarchy. So we are having multiple options. Whichever is suitable, we are going to opt that. So we like the democracy, we opted for that. Where we have a division of power, even if we see the worldwide, many countries have adopted democracy. Why? We are having advantages in democracy, like we have liberty, equality, dignity, freedom of speech, etc. But reality of these advantages is the same what they are being said. Do we really enjoy liberty, equality, freedom of speech? Is it so? So, if we talk about the reality, we can see a lot of mismatch among them. So, we can say democracies seem to be good in principle, but felt not to be so good in its practices. Now, which things we need to understand before the evaluation of the outcome of democracy? Why do we prefer democracy? Only for moral reason? Or there is some other prudential reasons? See, democracies are different in every country. If we compare the political parties and the democracy with India and France, they are totally different. In the same way, in USA. So there are large differences in democracy in each country. Thus, we can say that in every country, according to their social, cultural, and political, there are different forms from each other. So what is the common point through which we can say that the country is enjoying democracy? That common point we are going to search in this chapter. For democracy, we have certain expectations. If they are not fulfilled, that we discussed among us, that what we want is not enjoying the democracy. How can we say? See, we sit and discuss that what this government is doing, we are not at all enjoying the democracy. How we discuss and say that we are not enjoying democracy? Because under democracy, we have certain kind of expectations. What are those expectations? The expectations. Okay, now again, this image is also showing the disparity or the inequality in the share of wealth, where on the table, if you see the pizza,
which has been kept is nothing but the world's wealth which has been enjoyed by the 2% of the people. That 2% of the person is nothing but the rich person who was eating the majority, that is the biggest portion of the pizza is been eaten up by that 2% person, that is nothing but the rich people. And the 50% person is nothing but the population of the country. And the wealth that has been enjoyed by that person, that is the 50% of the population of the world, is enjoying only one slice of pizza. One single small piece of a pizza has been given to the 50% of the population from out of the world's wealth. And the remaining left out wealth has been enjoyed only by the handful of rich people. That is only 2% of the people is enjoying that world's wealth. So here they are just showing the disparity, that is the inequality in the share of wealth between the rich and the poor. Now if you see this image, it has been titled with the voice of poor. So this image signifies that the poor are voiceless. They are not empowered to raise their voice in front of the government in order to remove the disparities or the things that they are facing there, the disparities, the inequalities between the rich, middle and poor. So they are not able to raise their voice in front of the government. So this shows that how the poor are being treated by the government in a democratic country. So with this we can get to know that the poor are voiceless just because this person who is wearing a cloth with a certain number of patches which have been stitched, even one patch which has been stitched towards his mouth, which shows that he is voiceless. He cannot raise his voice in front of the government. Now if you closely look at this image, you can see that on your left hand side, the person holding a bag called garment is nothing but he's a person who is a garment, who is a representative of that country. And over him it has been written that what he knows about you. What he knows is nothing but what government knows about the public. And on the other side, there is the two people standing over there and holding a bag called public. That is nothing but these people are the public, that is we people, the citizens. And over them it has been written that what you know about it. Now through this image, what is the criteria of this image? What does this cartoon shows you? It shows that how the government is keeping an eye on the citizen through a lens, that is telescope, and knows each and every detail about the citizen. But on the other hand, the public, that is nothing but the citizen, they have no knowledge, no such information about the government. The government of India has a various tools through which information about the citizen can be taken. For example, Aadhaar card, ration cards, and the voter identity card, etc. Every 10 years, the government conducts census. In this census, there are the records of each adult member of the family, along with his or her sex, age, and education. There is a provision of registering birth, marriage, and death of the family members with a government institution. So here you can see that the government is having each and every small information about you. But you don't have even a small information regarding the government. How, what exactly you know about the government, how they are working on you. You don't have even a single knowledge about it. But the government is having a complete information about you.